everyone, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. I am Subhri Jaggi, your science educator. So today we are going to start with our second chapter of class 7 science, that is nutrition in animals. So here the topics to be covered in this chapter are nutrition in animals, digestion in human beings. We will talk about mouth, food pipes, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum and anus. Digestion in grass eating animals, digestion in amoeba. Okay, so in today's class, we are going to study about basic introduction of this chapter. Okay, so nutrition. When we are talking about nutrition, what is it is related to food, right? Okay, whenever we are talking about living organism, something which distinguishes from non-living organism is the process which is taking place inside the body of living organism, and that process is called life process. So yes, nutrition is nothing but it is related to food, right? In our previous lesson, nutrition in plants, where we spoke about nutrition in plants, how plants obtain their food through the process of photosynthesis, right? But unlike plants, animals can't make their own food. So here we are going to talk about how the animals obtain their food, how the food gets digested inside the body, how the food gets enters inside the body of animal, right? So nutrition, okay. So why are we learning in nutrition? Why we are talking about so much about nutrition? We do so many activities, right? We do so many activities, like we do jogging, we do running, we do yoga. So okay, if I ask you to run for 10 kilometers, what happened after some time? You tend to get tired after some time. Why? Because you are spending energy. So even your mental activities require energy, right? And even when you sleep, you require energy, because lot of process, life process is taking place inside your body. So energy is required for everything you do, right? So that energy comes from food. And what is food? Anything we drink, we eat for survival, right? That is called food. Okay, and food, there are nutrients present in the food. So what are nutrients? Nutrients are the substances, right, that are present in the food item that are required for the nourishment, for growth and development of the body, right? And now, what is nutrition? Okay, you know the nutrients. You already learned in class 6 what are nutrients. But what about nutrition? Can you define nutrition? Yes. Can anyone define nutrition? Nutrition, I'll tell you. Nutrition is the process of obtaining food and its utilization, absorption and digestion by the body is called nutrition. Okay. So there are 5 steps of nutrition, that is ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, egestion. So what is ingestion? What is ingestion? The process of taking food inside the body, inside the mouth, is called ingestion, right? Then digestion. What is digestion? The process of converting a complex food form into a simpler form and its utilization in the body is called digestion. So how this process is going on? How this process happened? We will discuss later in this chapter. Okay? Then absorption. After digestion, absorption comes. What do you mean by absorption? What do you mean by absorption? The process in which the digested food gets absorbed into the blood is called absorption. Then after assimilation, what is assimilation? Then the absorbed food, after absorption, then absorbed food get transferred into the different body parts for the and is utilized for its growth and maintenance. Okay. Then after egestion means the process of removal of undigested food. The process of removal of undigested food into the body, throughout the body, is called egestion. So there are 5 basic. So there are 5 basic steps of nutrition in animals, that is ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation and egestion. So let me show some slides. So with the help of some slides, I'll explain you rest of the topics, so that the topics will be more clear to you. Okay, so let me show some slides of nutrition in animals.
So what we have studied that green plants can prepare their own food by the process of photosynthesis, right? And animals cannot prepare their own food. They depend on plants for their food directly or indirectly. And we know that all organisms, including humans, require food for growth, for repairing damaged parts of their bodies, and for obtaining energy to carry out life process. So what is nutrition? Nutrition is a process of taking food. Animal nutrition is a process of taking food by an organism and its digestion, absorption, and utilization in the body, right? So we studied different steps in the process of nutrition, that is ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, and egestion. Okay, what is digestion? It is a process by which animals break down complex food substance into simpler substances. So different ways of taking the food. So the mode of procuring food into the body varies in different organisms. Each organism has special structure on its body to procure food. For example, hummingbird. Hummingbird, kind of food hummingbird eat, that is nectar. And mode of feeding, sucking. Okay, and mosquito kind of food they eat, blood, and mode of feeding, sucking. For and most of the examples are there, right? Human beings use their hands to take food into their mouth. Ruminating animals, jaise cow ho gaye, buffaloes ho gaye, they pick up food directly into their mouth. Paramecium has fine like structure called cilia all over its body, right? And the constant movement of cilia pushes the body particles along with the water current into its mouth. And how frog eats? Frog captures its prey with its long sticky tongue, and when an insect comes near the frog, it pushes out its sticky tongue to catch the insect. And spiders weave a sticky web. आपने देखा होगा इन विच स्मॉल इंसेक्ट्स गेट ट्रैप्ड, जिसे जाला कहते हैं, राइट? इन विच स्मॉल इंसेक्ट गेट ट्रैप्ड एंड दे इंजेक्ट डाइजेस्टिव जूसेस इन द बॉडी ऑफ इंसेक्ट्स विच डाइजेस्ट ऑल द पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी. द स्पाइडर देन सक्स अप द डाइजेस्टेड फूड. Another, I have told you the examples of insects like houseflies, butterflies, mosquitoes. They are modified to form a feeding tube to suck liquid food. So it is similar to the way we sip drinks with a straw, right? Hydra kya hai? Hydra it is a simple multicellular animal. It has a large number of tentacles around its mouth, which entangle small aquatic animals and kill them with their stinging cells, and the food is then pushed into the mouth, right? So we have seen that the mode of procuring food into the body varies in different organisms. So that's all about today. Tomorrow we will discuss about the digestion in humans, which is very important part of this chapter. So bye everyone. Have a nice day. Take care.